I will admit that it is his pastor, Peter Christian Hessling. Welcome again to another one of our interesting programs. I told you we were starting this new program of known as anti-nuclear boomerangs and cutting nukes. And this is the second one we're doing here. We're trying to encourage nuclear disarmament. And now that we're getting a new president of the United States, it's very important that we negotiate a new nuclear disarmament treaty. And as God said, blessed are the peacemakers. As Jesus says, blessed are the peacemakers, they're the children of God. And as God said, a day would come, Isaiah 2, for them to beat their souls into ploughshares. So we have to do more to have a nuclear disarmament. We have over 20,000 nuclear weapons in the world. We have to reduce them. And we really have to bring the Americans, all of us in America, bring the Russians, the Chinese, the North Koreans, the Indians, the Pakistan, the British, the French, all the countries in the world that have nuclear weapons together to have a nuclear disarmament treaty. Whether we can have a 10% reduction of nuclear weapons per year, that in 10 years we have close to over zero nuclear weapons. But there, this is a very important to see what's happening now, the close confrontation between Russia and America in Syria, the confrontations of Ukraine, which has actually threatened to use nuclear weapons. We can't take this lightly, we can't gamble anymore with nuclear weapons anymore. We really need to have a new treaty negotiated that will ban the first strike use of nuclear weapons, make them a war crime, and also ban the destructive power of these nuclear weapons, and ban the amount of nuclear weapons that countries can send up, as I say, North Korea, China, that is trying to build an ICBM, build submarine launch missiles, and Russia now building this SAMAT missile with 15 nuclear warheads. This is a very dangerous system. So we really need a treaty, a new nuclear disarmament treaty that bans the destructive power of these nuclear weapons. We can't just let them keep building more and more powerful weapons, and then one day they'll build one or two nuclear bombs that will completely destroy the entire world. So we really need a treaty. Whoever becomes our next president, whatever that president will retain on President Trump, a treaty that bans the destructive power of these nuclear weapons. I'm a patented inventor, and I have designed certain systems with the nuclear disarmament systems over the years. We're trying to encourage the countries to let them realize that technology exists where we can actually receive nuclear weapons, disarm them, and if you can't disarm, you don't have to boomerang them, send them back to the countries that want. And we really need to see peace with the Russians and the North Koreans and the Chinese and bring all the countries together. We have to live together as a family if we are going to survive on this planet. Now, as I've been telling you about this system that we designed years ago, we applied for two patents on it. We're still trying to get the patents on it. The reason why we applied for patents on it is to encourage the governments around the world to build these anti-nuclear systems. Let's tell you briefly about what we're going to build on it. We applied for two patents on it. We're still trying to get the government to build the patent on it. This one was filed this year. This patent application is 6237-3235. That was 4 years ago. The patent application was 0669-5536. Now this is an expanding missile system. And the Russians have come up with a SAMAT missile which has 15 nuclear warheads, has 15. And of course, we're praying that it is not going to go upward, it is going to go horizontal. It's probably going to send it from Russia or send it from somewhere. It's not the other nuclear missiles that go up to the goes horizontal, goes across. Or you can say latitudinally has 15 nuclear warheads on it. And that is why that is a very dangerous nuclear missile. That's why I said we have to ban the destructive power of these nuclear missiles, and also have a 24/7 safety inspection of all the nuclear weapons anyway by the International Atomic Agency to prevent nuclear war. Now, the system that I have designed, and we applied for some patents and we got some copyrights on it, is an expanding system that can expand. It means that we can expand larger than whatever system we have, but expand it in a larger way than the sound mode. So you'll be able to absorb that sound mode. Now, this expanding system, we have airbags inside here. Airbags that cushion the effect of the incoming missile, the sound mode, or what it would cushion the effect of that. And it's very good because we're able to, these airbags can also pick up water. A lot of the missiles now are put into the ocean, so it can pick up the water coming in to cushion the effect of the incoming nuclear missile water. Once that incoming missile comes in, we have saws here. These saws are going to be able to cut off the incoming water. Now this happens in a very fast pace. We have power saws that cut into the nuclear missile and can cut off warhead of cutlery that nuclear missile have. And we were saying that, you know, we have already had 1 or 2 or 3 or 7 or 8 or 10 or 12 or 15 warheads. We have multiple saws. We could have 15 saws in there. If they can put 15 missiles on one, 15 warheads on one missile, you could have 100 saws. We have saws that actually can cut the missile all around the circle. We also have saws on top and on bottom that will cut the missiles on the top and bottom. So the fact that it's 15, these multiple saws, not just one saw, you have multiple saws on the top, saws on the bottom that will cut those 15 missiles or warheads off. Once you cut off those 15 warheads, you're going to be able to disarm those, or you're going to send them. If you can't disarm, you're going to have to send it back to Russia. So this is a boomerang type system. The only way you're going to prevent these countries from launching nuclear missiles is when you have this type of system. Then if they launch on nuclear missiles, you can cut it off and send it back. Come from Russia, you send it back to Russia. If you come from North Korea, you can get that missile, cut it off, and send that missile back to North Korea or China. And that's the only way we're going to be able to prevent these countries from wanting to use nuclear missiles. As I said, we have entered that nuclear missile boomerang age. So the fact that they have 15 warheads on, we could have 100 different saws. We can have saws that cut in a certain way, cut the missile. At the same time, we have saws that are cutting from the top, so you're cutting these warheads from all different directions, so you can quickly cut off those 15 nuclear warheads and try and disarm them. If you can disarm them, you're going to send them back to Russia. So we have really entered the nuclear missile boomerang age. What we're really trying to do is to bring all the countries to the negotiating table and realize that they have to get rid of nuclear weapons. And nuclear weapons are self-destructive, and we have to get rid of them. And this is their purpose of doing so, whether we get as our new president, whether we have President Clinton or President Trump, we need to get this new nuclear disarmament treaty that we want to establish a 24/7 safety inspection by the international atomic regions of all nuclear weapons in the world on a 24/7 basis to prevent the use of nuclear weapons, ban the destructive power of nuclear weapons, and ban the amount of them that they can send up at one day. We have to ban the megatons, the amount of megatons that Russia and China and North Korea are trying to put into these nuclear weapons. If we're going to save the world and make sure that our children and grandchildren live in a peaceful civil war, we have to do what we can do with nuclear weapons. So, need our next president of the United Nations and the International Atomic Agency to take a stronger position on nuclear disarmament. But a treaty that will have a 10% reduction per year in 10 years of observing nuclear weapons, and a 20% reduction in 5 years of observing nuclear weapons. So, there is a lot of technology that you can do. And I think that this system in trying to, when you can actually cut, you can actually cut a nuclear missile with a metal saw, cut it in half, that is going to change, you can say, to save humanity. That is going to be just as important as splitting the atomic bomb. That will be a tremendous scientific advancement, be able to cut these nuclear missiles in half, disarm them, and send them back. What we really need to do here is, this is all the weapons on the military, but what we really need to do is to, create these anti-nuclear barrier zones, okay? We have here, over here, this is a remarkable outfit, you can see it all over. What we are doing, what we really need to do is create these zones here that would either longitudinal or latitudinal. And inside these zones, we call them anti-nuclear barriers, where you have radar and you have systems that are constantly, you have a 24/7 barrier to nuclear weapons. You not just have this open, the problem is that we have this open, the whole earth is just open, there's open space. We do have radar and so forth, but we need to have a stronger international 24/7 system. We were creating these anti-nuclear zone barriers where no nuclear missile can penetrate it. So you see, in here you have radar, you have like, you can call it, something they want to call it automatic, I don't want to call it kill zones for nuclear weapons, but any nuclear missile that could inside these zones would be destroyed. You'd have a 24 system in all of these zones around the world that would monitor nuclear weapons, and any nuclear missile that comes into this zone, because we have radar, or we have boomerangs, or we have rockets that shoot down nuclear weapons, or you know, any nuclear weapon that comes in. We have the specified anti-nuclear zones or anti-nuclear kill zones, but any nuclear weapon that comes into these zones, you're going to be able to destroy. So we're going to talk to more about that. There's a work together when it's president, we need them to move in this direction, the United Nations and the International Atomic Agency and all kinds of people that take a stronger position on preventing nuclear weapons. Remember to look at my book coming out, the entire 24/7 safety inspection, Save the World, Nuclear and Global Warming, by me, Peter Christian Hessen. I have that coming out, I'll tell you. I'm never finishing it, and I hope you look forward to that. Really need to have a strong stand on having nuclear disarmament and also global warming. I call it the nuclear missile boomerang age. We really need to get oil companies to take up some of the water out of the ocean, purify the oil companies, can never take up the ocean water, or license the water from the ocean, and they can sell it, right? They can purify the water and sell it, they've got to make more money, Puritan Russian novels and selling it than from popular novels. So we had to do all companies to take up that rising ocean level deal and move forward and reducing ocean level and reducing pollution. I'm going to be talking more about that, but we also need to make the rest of the military. And I think a lot of people are afraid of the robotic military, but a robotic military that is based on the principle of saving civilians and rescuing civilians will be a very effective as saving the lives of the veterans and saving people who are dying more as well. Whereas we really have to go to the robotic military, and I'm going to be talking more about that. That we can build out a robotic military where we don't have to send away women and men of war to fight these wars and to fight these terrorists. A robotic system that is based on the principle of rescuing civilians and evacuating civilians and protecting civilians. That will lead us to the world of peace and more peace we can save our lives for us again. There are all sorts of music coming out, I love the great city coming out, Missing of the Hearts, Frozen Magazine of Songs, and we have a president of the working rap, April, you know, the Atlantic Magazine of Songs, actually, the gospel is doing great by going to Amazon.com. There are sorts of music on Tidal, and perhaps a lot of music coming out, Boomerang, Antidote, Last Recording, all the gospel music. You can also need to come up and Jesus. Peace on earth. There are many people in the world that want peace. Christians, Muslims, Hindus, Jews, Palestinians, all the people, Black, African Americans, American Palestinians, Black lives matter, all lives matter. Let's have diversity and discrimination, and discrimination against Blacks and American Americans, African Americans, Indian Americans, Black lives and all that diversity. Peace on earth. Keep it on earth. Avengers. Peter Christopher. Thank you. Peace and love. Pass the bit of Christmas. Peace and love.